It's critically endangered. There are only about 400 plus individuals left in the wild. And merong notion na the cause of its dwindling population is hunting. Of course, merong factor. But the truth is, the main culprits are habitat loss, pagkasira ng kanyang habitat, and habitat fragmentation. So nagpuputol-putol yung kanyang tirahan. So maaaring dito may forest, tapos yung isang portion will be given over to commercial agriculture, tapos kabilang forest. So ano nangyayari? Na-isolate yung population. And so ang mga damaraw kamag-anak ay ng kalabaw, ng cow, they all belong to the bovine family. And bovines are prolific reproducer. Walang issue sa pagre-reproduce nila. Madali silang wana. But the problem is when the populations are isolated, the tendency for inbreeding grows higher, and that compromises the genetic biodiversity of the species. So dahil sila-sila lang yung nagbe-breed, hindi nila mahanap yung ibang population kasi nga maaaring wala ng habitat or putol na yung habitat, humihina yung next generation. Mabilis mamatay, mabilis magkasakit. So yun yung main culprit. Now, photographing animals in their natural habitat is very powerful kasi it strengthens the call to protect natural places, the natural world, protect ecosystems. Because if you only call for protection of species of wildlife, magkakaroon ng notion na, okay, hulihin natin, tapos alagaan natin sa zoo. That's not the best way to do it. The best way is always to protect the habitat and let them live in their natural home. And speaking of seeing an iconic species in the wild, this is one of my most favorite photos ever. Pangalan niya si Pamarek III. He's a fledgling Philippine eagle. We photographed this bird in the forest of Okinawa. At nakaharap namin siya sa tulong ng mga kitanglad volunteers. Yung mga kitanglad volunteers, they are made up of mga lumad, mga talaanting, daraguyan, apokidong daraguyan at higaunan. And they are part of the community. And hindi namin makikita si Pamarayag III kung wala yung mga bird guides namin. Hindi lang mga enthusiasts, mga birders yung nakikinabang sa traditional wisdom and indigenous wisdom and experiences, kundi pati science. Yung mga bird guides namin noon, sila din yung bird guides ng mga sa Philippine Eagle Foundation, ng mga scientists, ng mga researchers. So this photo of Pamarayag III is not only a call to protect an iconic species. It's not only a call to protect its habitat, but also a call to recognize that community participation and indigenous leadership are necessary to protect our natural heritage. Okay. So, itong set ng photos na to, this is how I usually do my photography now. So, of course, meron pa rin element ng, meron pa rin aesthetic quality. That's just me being an artist. But now there's also a diagnostic element to it. When I say diagnostic, I highlight the feature of the species. So you'll see, this by the way is a set of photos for gumihan, Philippine native tree. Artocarpus, Aristocarpus. And you'll see its fruits na parang malaking rambutan. You'll see, yes, parang marang, creamy and sweet yung lasa niya. Then the leaves, yung habit ng puno. So I do my photography this way kasi it's beneficial to the work that I do, that I'm currently doing. When a species is unknown to me and I photograph it this way, it's easier for experts and those with more knowledge to help me ID the species. Kasi makikita nila yung mga distinguishing features. Now you'll ask, saan ka nagpapa-ID? Sinong tumutulong sa'yo? Well, over the years, syempre, meron na tayong pwedeng EPM na botanist, na ornithologist. Pero, when I was starting my education, there were several Facebook groups that were instrumental, and I'm going to share it with you. So if you're interested to learn more about our Philippine biodiversity, our country's biodiversity, here are some recommended Facebook groups you can join. So you have some for flora, for trees and plants, you have some for birds, even for reptiles and amphibians if you like snakes, for waterflies, Philippine Lepidoptera, for wild mushrooms. One of my, for me, the top Facebook group is COS Digital for Flora of the Philippines. So in addition to the Facebook group, we also have an online database. So if you visit this URL here, you'll be taken to this page. And here is the most exhaustive, the most comprehensive list of Philippine plants, not Philippine plants, not just Philippines, but plants found in the Philippines, both native and exotic. So, wala nga lang local names, pero it has scientific names, yung distribution, yung saan natatagpuan, and most of the time, there are photos. Pero, meron pa ding mga species na walang diagnostic photos or photos at all. Now, I want my photography to help build this database because this database has been very, very important to my work. So yung pinakita kong set ng photos sa inyo, I've contributed it to this database. So the way CDFP works, you have to know the scientific name, yun lang yung catch. So for gumihan, Artocarpus elisicarpus, type in the genus name, so that's Artocarpus. Then it will take you to the page of the family where it belongs. So it's alphabetical, so you have to scroll. Then there, by the side of the scientific name, my photograph na icon. If you click that, this page will show. So itong last row, itong second row, those are my photos. And this is very important when you're comparing or confirming the species of a plant. I've used this database many, many times. And researchers also use this. And I'm very sure many future citizen scientists and researchers will also benefit from this database. So in total, I just recently started submitting photos a couple of months ago. And there are 22 photos from me in the database for 3 species. So I think that's how we can revolutionize photography. When we allow it to evolve with intention and purpose, the impact can be deep and far. Now, it can be an academic reference, it can be a proof of concept, a tool for conservation, and a proof of successful conservation. And it can democratize academic knowledge and bring science closer to the people. So academic, scientific, social, and even political yung pwedeng paggamitan ng mga photographs natin. Now you probably say, well, Celine, in order to create photos like the ones you've shown us, kailangan natin ng specialized gear na mahal. And that's very valid. And it's true. Gear matters, sabi nga nung mga nauna natin speaker. But I hope that doesn't limit you or dissuade you from, you know, evolving your photography. So let me share 2 more photos. So the one on the yandun. So it looks like flowers embedded on a leaf. Those are leaf galls. So kung nakita niyo yung sa santol, bukol-bukol. So that's a form, that's another adaptation of leaf galls. And this one here, it's a photo of a remarkable inflorescence, remarkable flowers of a native tree, Meliusa vidalii, or takulaw in the local language. And these are both created using a mobile phone. And I want to emphasize that because that photo over there of the leaf, when I posted it on COS Digital Flora of the Philippines Facebook group, I had no idea what it was. So I asked what it was, and there are scientists in that group, so they were able to explain this occurrence, and it started a conversation. It was able to, you know, start a conversation, a discussion, an explanation to this concept na na-encounter na pala natin kung meron tayong santol or nakita tayo ng santol. Kasi very common siya sa santol for some reason. But it can become remarkable, and even with a mobile phone, you can photograph it. And then isang photo, it was also able to help enrich the CDFP database. So before I contributed this photo, yung photo lang nitong species na to ay bunga at dahon. And I'm very sure these photos will be very helpful to somebody someday. So what I'm trying to say is, we have such amazing technology in our hands, in our pockets. And let's make use of that. Let's use our phones not to distract us, but to help us better understand and share the world's view. And the power of photography cannot only mainstream biodiversity or anything for that matter. It can redefine how we do things and how we perceive things, hopefully for the better. In the same way that we can change or redefine the way we do and perceive photography, it can be truly transformative. So I hope the examples I've shown you will empower you to create and document the world in a new light, literally and figuratively. Yung mga larawan. Yung mga litrato at larawan na gagawin sana natin. I-harness natin yung power niya in order to be compassionate in a way that it honors both our vision and those of the ones portrayed. Na sana, makapag-ambag siya at makatulong sa paglikha ng isang mundong mas mabuti, mas mapangunawa at mas mapagpalaya. Napaka-powerful ng photography, and it is okay to use it for self-expression as a personal, personal thing, something intimate. But it can also be revolutionary and evolutionary. And I hope you realize that after this talk. Nakasisili. Palaging para sa sariling buhay at sa tunay at galak na kalayaan. Just one.